Hello everyone, and welcome to How-FixIT. If your Nintendo Switch 2 power button is not responding, or if the volume buttons are stuck or no longer working, don't worry. I'm here to help. In this video, I'll show you how to replace the power and volume button flex cable on a Nintendo Switch 2 with a clear step-by-step repair guide. For this repair, you will need two screwdrivers, a 2.0 tri-wing and a Phillips No. 1 screwdriver. Plastic pry tools and a pair of tweezers will also be helpful during the repair process. You'll also need thermal putty. I'll specify the type later. You'll find links to all the necessary tools and replacement parts in the video description below. Before you start disassembling the console, I highly recommend using a magnetic mat. The Nintendo Switch 2 has a lot of small screws of different sizes, and keeping track of them is really important for an easy reassembly process. A magnetic mat helps you organize the screws by sections and prevents them from getting lost, since they stay attached to the mat. It's a simple but very helpful tool when working on compact devices like Switch 2. Okay, let's get started. Make sure to turn off the console completely and remove the Joy-Cons. Lift the kickstand and remove the two screws using a tri-wing screwdriver. Next, remove the two screws near the charging port at the bottom of the console, as well as the single screw located at the top edge of the case. Now, we need to peel off these stickers. To remove them carefully, use a pair of curved tweezers. Start by prying up the sticker from the inner side near the Joy-Con connector. Insert a second pair of tweezers in the small gap and begin peeling the sticker along the edge of the chassis. This is how easily you can remove the stickers without causing any damage. Remove the second sticker using the same method. Remove the two screws located beneath each of the stickers on both sides. Use a plastic spudger to gently pry up the bottom cover. Then, release the latches through the small openings to remove the back cover. Remove the screws securing the antenna modules, then disconnect the antenna wires from the main board before proceeding to remove the metal plate. The thermal putty holds the metal plate slightly in place on this side. Carefully begin lifting it with a plastic spatula. Disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard before proceeding to prevent any short circuits. open the connector latch and disconnect the button flex cable from the main board. Once it's detached, you can remove and replace the button flex cable. If your power or volume buttons are jammed, unresponsive, or completely broken, replacing the button flex cable should fix the issue. I've included links to the replacement power and volume button flex cable for the Nintendo Switch 2 in the video description below. Let's proceed with installing the new button flex cable and reassembling the console. When installing the new flex cable, make sure it fits securely into the designated grooves. Proper alignment is essential for the power and volume buttons to function correctly. Once the cable is correctly positioned, reconnect it to the main board and close the latch to secure the connection. Now, let's talk about that pink material between the heatsink and backplate. That's thermal putty, not paste. Unlike standard thermal paste, which works well only in thin layers with tight pressure, thermal putty is designed to fill larger gaps. In the Nintendo Switch 2, there's a significant space, around 1.5 millimeters, between the heat pipe and the backplate. Thermal paste simply isn't thick enough to handle this properly and would lead to poor heat transfer and overheating issues. If you don't have fresh thermal putty and the old one is still elastic, you can temporarily reuse it until you obtain a new supply. However, replacing it with fresh thermal putty is recommended for optimal thermal performance. When selecting a suitable thermal putty, I recommend Thermal Grizzly Putty, which comes in three variants: Basic, Advanced, and Pro, each differing in thermal conductivity, consistency, and price. TG Putty Pro is unnecessary for this application. It is designed for extreme heat transfer scenarios such as servers or high performance overclocking. Its thermal performance, density, and cost are excessive for a mobile console like the Switch 2. TG Putty Advanced is an excellent compromise between thermal conductivity and ease of application. It performs reliably in the area between the heat pipe and the back cover, where the gap is approximately 1.5 millimeters. It does not leak and remains stable under vibration and heat, making it ideal for this repair. TG Putty Basic is a more budget-friendly option that still performs, particularly if the console is used under moderate load. Visually, its color is very similar to the original thermal putty used in factory-assembled consoles, making it a practical choice for general use. I'm going to use TG Putty Advanced. It has excellent thermal conductivity at around 6.2 watts per meter Kelvin and stays in place without drying out or leaking. It's a perfect replacement for the original thermal putty. Remove the old thermal putty and wipe the surface to eliminate any remaining residue. Then, apply fresh thermal putty and spread it evenly along the heat pipe using the spatula included with the TG Putty. Ensure the layer is smooth and covers the contact surface thoroughly for optimal thermal conductivity. Install the backplate and secure it with the appropriate screws. The applied pressure will evenly distribute the thermal putty, forming the optimal contact layer across the surface of the heat pipe for efficient heat transfer. reattach the back cover, secure it with the screws, and replace the original stickers to complete the assembly. If you found this guide helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more tech tips and guides. Visit our website for more tech insights and do-it-yourself guides. Remember, every tech challenge is an opportunity to learn and grow. I really appreciate you watching my video guide. Feel free to ask any questions about Nintendo Switch 2 maintenance in the comments. By the way, if you're experiencing issues with your Joy-Cons or Pro Controller, such as analog stick drift or sticky buttons, check out my tutorial on cleaning and restoring your controller. For more details, refer to the helpful links in the video description. Thanks for watching How-FixIT, and see you in the next video.